Welcome to part two of this series on the best free PowerPoint templates you can download on the web today. Let's go ahead and look at top template number four, the 26-slide corporate template pack by 24 slides. This template is a very elegant, nice template that you can use for what I would recommend is any sort of document style presentation. If I go to the slide sort of view, you'll see among the 25 options that you get, these first, I would say these second two and three are just descriptions of their services. So you can probably just delete these from your presentation. And the others you get will fit into this nice corporate template, which as you can see, the font size is quite small and there is a fair amount of data on all of these slides, so I would recommend using these slides for something that is more of a document that's meant to be emailed or printed or delivered in a very small environment rather than for a larger live presentation sort of a setting. This template includes a variety of different layouts, including some options here for some UI sort of design, along with a map here that is a picture, and some other options for backgrounds with images that are slightly darker. What I like about this template is I like this paintbrush effect that you find here on the background. This is used in almost every single one of the slides and it ties the presentation nicely together. One thing to keep in mind, this presentation is built using the SlidesGo UI font. So make sure you have that installed on your computer if you don't have it already in order to be able to see this properly. And also the Calibri font, which you should have already on your computer. This template comes only in a widescreen format, only 16:9. So if you want a different format, you're going to have to adjust the slide size yourself to standard and then tweak anything that gets edited along the way. I do also like the color palette for this template, which you can see has been added here along the side of the slide space, which will not be shown obviously when you present in SlideShow or when you print. But these colors are pretty nice and they're fairly low in saturation, which means they'll look good on almost all projectors out there. So that is also another good piece of news for this template. Keep in mind, if I go to the slide master view, that this template is built almost all correctly here in the child layouts area. However, it is not associated very well to the parent slide. So the parent slide formatting does not match any of the formatting in the rest of this presentation. And that's problematic because anytime that you add or remove a title, for example, if you know you were to add the title back, the title jumps back here and that's going to look bizarre. And also when you copy and paste slides back and forth, some funny things will probably happen because this template was not built 100% correctly based on the slide master. So that is something to keep in mind. And in particular, layouts like number 23, for example, is built actually on a blank layout that's completely blank. So that means that if you inadvertently nudge your title and you want it to be back where it was, you don't have time, you don't have enough control Z's, or maybe you did it a while back, you close the presentation, you open it again. There's no way if you hit reset, nothing happens. The title stays in the same position. So you only have control Z to actually get you back there. And if you've closed your presentation, then that's no longer effective. So that is just something to keep in mind for a few of the slides here on this template. And if you want to learn more about those warnings, please check out the blog post in the description below where I list out exactly all of the errors you can find in this template. But overall, it's a pretty good template, and I would recommend using it, just being aware of some of these issues. One thing to keep in mind is this template comes with all pictures filled in, all the placeholders have been filled in. So if you wanted to replace this, you could simply delete it, and then you would have the placeholder where you could then insert any of the pictures that you wanted to include in your template. And again, you could send to the back or potentially hit the reset button to get everything to fit correctly the way it's meant to look. For anything that perhaps is behind of another shape, in this situation we have a couple masks. We have this top one here, the paintbrush effect, and we have another image here, I sort of say a shape, that has a transparency to make this image darker. You're going to need to move this away first, before you can delete this in order to insert your own picture. However, in this situation, you'll notice there's no icon that appears, and that means that this presentation was built on a blank layout and there are no placeholders for the picture. So that means that you're going to have to insert your own picture in the back and then reapply, hit reset, nothing happens. Again, this is a frustration for working with not a properly built template. You'll just have to, again, yourself manually go in and place this in the right place yourself, and that's what happens when you deal with a custom layout that is built without any of the placeholders that are set in the template. free PowerPoint template number 5, the Master's Thesis by SlidesGo. And I love this template. How beautiful does this look? Let me go to slide sort of view and show you how this template looks overall when you see it from the bird's eye view. It's very, very pretty, very graphically designed. I love the, let me zoom in just a little bit here. I love the light outlines that we get here around some of the pictures. I love that the layout changes a lot from slide to slide. It really catches your attention. I love the little title sort of box here along with this page number that sits at the very top of each one of these layouts. That way it keeps a consistency throughout the presentation when you print it, which I believe is the best way to use this presentation. It's got fairly small font and I think is designed to be mostly presented as a printed document or a document viewed in a small setting. You're going to have this pink element that carries through throughout the entire presentation, and I think that looks very nice. Now, this layout includes 15 pre-designed layouts in this template. It comes only in a widescreen 16:9 format, and it does use the Josephine Sans and Josephine Slab fonts, so you do need to make sure that you have those included in your version of PowerPoint. You may need to download those if you don't have them to make sure that you can see this template the way that it's designed to be seen, and you can always adjust the fonts after yourself. Another nice thing about this template is that it includes some really nice little graphics and icons and maps that you can use in your own presentation when you're adjusting this template for your own needs. And I do want to point out that this template, also comes in a Google Slides version. So if you wanted to use that in Google Slides, you're absolutely able to do that very easily. The next thing to know about this Master's Thesis Free template is that while the colors are very pretty, I do like these colors a lot, some of them are fairly high in saturation, so that means that when you are projecting them, they may not look that great on computer. Also, you'll notice when you insert a new rectangle, these colors don't match the colors that you have in this template. So this means that the template was built without a theme, without a color palette, and these colors are all adjusted, customized one by one. So that means that if you were to go and, you know, decide that you wanted to change the color scheme, well, absolutely nothing would change. So that's really frustrating. That means that you have to adjust the colors here in the normal view one by one, and you would have to go back into the Slide Master view and select these colors, select each one of these, and change them one by one. And that takes a fair amount of time. And because the parent slide here on the parent layout is not built correctly to fit the style of the rest of this presentation, even if you were to make a change to this font, for example, to make it orange for any reason, it doesn't even change. So it looks like there's some sort of error happening with this layout. And I would just be very cautious to, you know, to use some of these if you are using slides from this template in other presentations. So you'd have to do it one by one, you'd have to change this, etc., and that would just be very, very time consuming. So this template is really great if you're just going to use it as is, if you're literally going to just copy and paste your content in, you know, change the text, change the images. That is a pretty easy way to use this template, but keep in mind if you're copy and pasting slides to and from this presentation with other presentations, you might get some funny, weird formatting things that happen, and that's just something to keep in mind. Another thing to keep in mind, again, is that a lot of these pictures are inserted in the normal view, so if you hit reset, nothing will adjust. So for example, if I were to delete this picture, oh, that was just a mask, let me undo that, move this down, I will delete this picture. If I hit reset, nothing happens. First of all, this gets weirded out, so something was changed here, and there is no placeholder for me to insert a picture, so I would have to drag in a picture myself and crop it and format it and make it fit perfectly and then place this back on top of here. So that those are just some of the limitations to be aware of with this template, but this template is very pretty. It's very aesthetically pleasing, and if you're going to make a one-off situation presentation, you can absolutely use this template. Just copy and paste your content in and adjust some things, and if you don't need to make too many changes, this template is good as golden. So that is the Master's Thesis template by SlidesGo. Free PowerPoint template number 6, Memphis Marketing Plan by SlidesGo. This is another beautifully designed PowerPoint template by SlidesGo. Now again, the word template here is a little bit tricky because this is only a partially well-designed template, but I want to point this one out because it is really very pretty. Very suitable for a fashion brand, for a lifestyle company, potentially even a health and fitness or a children's products. It's a very light and beautifully designed, casual and fun template. This template uses a very bright and colorful color palette, which you can obviously adjust to your own needs. But let me go into the slide sort of view so you can see it from a broader perspective. This template includes 25 pre-designed slide layouts. And you'll notice that we have these sort of paint brush effects that carry throughout the presentation, along with sometimes with little dots. They look like paintbrush dots that have been added, and it includes some very bright colors. This template, again, by SlidesGo, includes graphics and icons and map pictures that you can use in your own presentation, so that's also very nice. As for other SlidesGo presentations, this includes a Google Slides version if you want to download that instead and use it in Google Slides. And again, we only have the widescreen format available, so if you wanted to change the slide size dimensions, you'd have to do that manually yourself. Now, one thing to keep in mind again is that the font here is using Josephine Sans and Arial. Arial you probably already have on your computer. Josephine Sans you may not have, so you'll want to download that for yourself in order to use this template the way it was designed to be used. One thing to keep in mind is a lot of these elements are simply shapes that have been added on here in the normal view. Some of them are included in the Slide Master here, but not all of them, and some of them have been added on later. So that is just something to keep in mind, but you can absolutely take these and reuse them in your own presentations, which is pretty neat. And you can also change the color because they are actually shapes instead of pictures. So if you wanted to change the coloring of this theme, you could do that by changing those colors. Now, do keep in mind that the only way to do that would be to adjust these yourself, because if you were to change the color scheme, you'll notice that nothing happens. Because this template wasn't built fully with a theme and a color palette built into it, the colors don't change at all. So that's a bit problematic if you wanted to make any adjustments to this template very quickly. You'll also notice that the parent slide layout is not built out in a way that matches any of the rest of the content in this template. So if you were to remove the title and add it back in, it's going to look very different from how the others look and how you maybe want it to look to match the initial design of the PowerPoint template. So those are just a few things to keep in mind about this template. Now, one other thing about these colors is they may be a little bit high in saturation, so you'll want to test that. This blue, for example, can be a little bit bright, so make sure you test that on your own computer and projector before you present in front of somebody else, or change the colors to match something that will be a little bit less bright. If you go to certain slides, you'll also notice that these pictures here were added in the background of the slide. So if you go to Format Background, this is actually a picture that was added in here, and so there is no way to edit it. So the only way to change this picture to something you want is to insert your own picture into the background, or to remove the background to make it a solid fill. You can make it automatic so that it's white, and then you can insert your own picture directly on top of this in the normal view. So one thing you could do if you wanted to insert your own picture, you could, for example, just drag it in here. You would have to, resize it and format it, crop to aspect ratio 16:9. Just do this really quickly to show you, and you would stretch it to fit. And now the thing is, you'd want to send it all the way to the back, right? The only thing is, the background image that you have here in the Slide Master view, this is actually added, and it is now created, because it's a shape, it is going to fit on the background of the slide. So what you'd have to do is you should copy this, close the master view, come in here, paste it in, and send all of this to the back, including your picture, that way they all go to the back, and then you'd be able to see that. Now, this looks a bit weird because we're covering her face. You probably wouldn't want to do that. You would adjust it something like this. But that is the problem with dealing with something where there are no placeholders. You've had to go around what the initial layout was designed to do and find a way to make it fit yourself. So those are just a few things to be aware of when you are using this template. And if you can use it just as is, that is perfect because it's beautifully designed and designed to be used just this way. So that is the Memphis Marketing Plan by SlidesGo. And that wraps up this second part of the best free PowerPoint templates on the web. In the next video, I'll show you the next best ones, starting with a fun and playful pitch deck template. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, thumbs up down below, leave a comment, and make sure to subscribe to our channel with the notification turned on to find out when we release our next awesome PowerPoint tutorial. Thanks, and I'll see you at Happy Hour.